a best of three series that will determine who moves on to the upper group or the lower group. Again, the Swiss format making this very interesting. But above all else, we're just really excited to watch good pro Dota here. Of course, EG versus TNC should be a great matchup. My name is Mott. Along with me today is Trent Pax. And Trent, how are you feeling after that great first series we just watched?
Pretty excited. Nice to see SG Esports take a win, force us to game three. Of course, we want turn to ban. Two games. See if they can close it out rather quick. But TNC, of course, the SEA region here to represent. Unfortunately, despite all of our recent SEA casting between the two of us, not too much of TNC. They haven't been involved in too many tournaments other than the Summit, which where they got knocked out pretty early. So.
Yeah, and to be fair, the teams they got knocked out by, Happy Feet, very strong. I don't want to call them up and coming, but a pretty solid team in their own right. And then Warriors Gaming Unity, of course, another extraordinarily strong team in the SEA region. So a couple of losses for TNC. And they will end up picking up the CM, which is a hero they like to go for themselves. The Nyx Assassin. I was wondering when we're going to get to see this hero, Trent, as Nyx has been a pretty hot commodity as of recently in terms of like offlanes or maybe even picking him in that support role. You know, we talked about offlaners. Nyx Assassin is definitely one of them, I think.
Yep. Very strong hero. He especially is nice at countering out heroes, even just from being picked. Like, it's one thing to counter them.
10 seconds remaining.
That, but he's a reliable enough hero that you can pick him early on in the draft. He has that little bit of flexibility where he can go position, but more often than not, he'll probably just be in our offlane role here. But you don't really want to pick Invoker for a Sumail, perhaps, because of this. And those kind of things can cause him some trouble. The Ember Spirit's another big one, especially with the Lifestealer. Could be a good vessel. He's someone who can abuse Living Armor quite a bit, and you might hesitate a little bit to pick him into the CM route and the Carapace of Nyx.
Yeah, absolutely. A couple of good targeted bans against EG, known for their Warlock. The Io, of course, versus Roval Ban, not surprising there. Interesting to note, Ogre's picked up for TNC, so now we're looking at Nyx Assassin definitely going to the offlane trend. Ogre, CM, working together in that support position. At least they should be. So we'll see a Bloodlust coming out and whatever hero they want that works well with Bloodlust.
Yeah, crazy to see Ogre again. I mean,
it's been a while, man.
Not getting the love. He slayed it in the Kiev Majors. He had one of the highest win rates, especially compared to pick rate. No one was even close to this guy across all the different regions. He definitely came out on top, even mostly because of these bans on, well, Monkey King and Earth Spirit. And speak the devils there. Monkey King just not even going to be mentioned in this draft with that Ogre pick.
Yeah, that's crazy to think after that first series where it was picked all three games and played pretty well in every single game, especially from Jerax. But TNC will forego it. They'll say, we'll pick up a Slark for ourselves, and then we already have our support, so we don't need to worry about a Monkey King.
We're flying through this draft, dude.
Yeah, we are. We've
seen
a lot
of
drafts recently. Yeah, this has happened so often for us. I don't know why, but every time Trent and I get to cast a game, it's just like, all right, we'll have 2 minutes of reserve time left going into the last pick, and then we can really use it, draw it out, and then... But some very quick drafts. So yeah, we're going to see. Obviously, I think EG here, Trent, are the favorites over TNC, but they've not maybe had the best results at DAC. They're looking to get back on that winning track, get through to that upper bracket potentially, and we'll see what happens here, and avoid elimination early on in this tournament, I should say.
Yeah, in terms of the main event, I think their losses were to, they lost to Newbie, and they in the group stage, they got 2-0'd by IG, so a lot of their losses were against some of the stronger teams that were even at the event. So, of course, EG is still very well-respected. I think having this much reserve time is great from this point, because obviously with Sumail being left in the picks here and having to pick that before the counter can come out from TNC, they want as much time as possible to nail this one on down here with Arteezy. Often getting this Lifestealer, often getting ditched quite a bit in the safe lane. They definitely tend to put more of that pressure on keeping Sumail safe and making sure that his early game goes well. So Lifestealer probably just going to be sent away to get his Midas. EG, one of the first teams to really start abusing the Midas, even before these newer changes to the item. They were stacking so many on the squad. So we'll see if RTZ can at least get the space to get that going before the armlets. If he's too heavily pressured, he might be forced into an earlier armlet to do these rotations with either our offlaner or our core here for Sumail.
Yeah, well, that's going to be the thing, too. We're looking for a universe hero. Axe has been banned out, something that he's been playing pretty recently up until DAC.
Very good. So yeah, those Slark,
two,
too.
Those two big cores. Obviously, we don't have to really state how big of an impact Sumail and universe have on this EG squad, and their heroes are going to be absolutely crucial to the draft. Invoker's been something that they've been picking up a lot in the mid lane if they want to go for that. Again, it's I think, good with the Shadow Shaman. Open Wound's not bad as well. Easily able to bring down some of these heroes, although there's a Nyx in the game. They'll go for the Troll, though, to pick it up, and that's going to start things off in potentially the mid lane.
Okay. Might be able to get themselves a decent chain stun via bashes onto the Slark, perhaps. Not a hero that suffers too much from the Nyx Assassin, which is something that a lot of mid heroes have trouble with. Very solid ban, of course, on the Magnus. You almost think the EG must have had something else in mind than a Magnus, because that's definitely the first ban you think of with Troll Warlord these days, with another core available in the Lifestealer to help out.
Yeah.
Their push is very strong with the Lifestealer and the Troll Warlord, both very good building hitters. They have the backup of the Terrain Protector. They have the Shadow Shaman Serpent Wards here. So really the last thing they're missing would be like another layer of teamfight control that could come out here from Universe. I don't know if we'll get another. Yeah, like Enigma would be a perfect kind of hero, especially against Slark.
Yeah. I mean, he has played it in the past, and I imagine he could go
his
for that
Puck
if he wants
too.
To. Yeah, Puck has been another hero that he's played recently as well. What else is there? Legion, of course, banned in first overall. We talked about how popular Legion is now. Going back to some of the other tournaments like DPL, it's been picked a ton. I mean, almost
still
every game.
Here, but
that
the
is
Knicks
true. Yeah,
and the CM.
But it is. It does fit a universe. It is his hero, pretty much. So if they want to go for it, Clockwork. I'm not sure. Is that the hero? I mean, again, we know Universe's Clockwork is pretty dominant, but I'm not
sure. There's a lot of good
here.
Options here. If it wasn't for the Slark, I'd say a Batrider too. But that gives you some, you know, hesitation of picking it. But it will be his Faceless Void.
Man.
Despite not having the absolute best damage to go in, we will be blessed with the Universe Chronos once again, ladies
you
and gentlemen.
You have the Battle Trance. Yeah, this is getting flashbacks.
It's been a while.
Day. It has been. It's been a little bit. Faceless Void has been kind of on the shelf for a lot of the teams. So far, in three of the four games we've cast today, Trent, Faceless Void has been in them. So he's making a comeback, man. I don't know if it's just an early group stage thing, because we know how the meta can change between group stages and up into the playoffs. So that's something to keep in mind. But for right now, he seems like he's back, at least from these three games.
Maybe it's some scrim results coming out. A lot of teams picking him, but it's been 5 months since he's played this Faceless Void. So very excited to watch this again.
HFN, yeah, that one sick Chronosphere, yeah.
Damn.
It's going to be a good one, man. Again, Battle Trance, again, not much, so, like you mentioned, outside of it. Shadow Shaman, though, with Serpent Wards, a lot of nuke damage as well with this Aether Shock is something to consider, but it's Battle Trance, I think, that they really wanted to use. And then Troll Warlord, of course, going ranged axes is certainly going to help, too.
There are some concerns, I would say. Like, the Infest Bomb Carriers are not super ideal here from Evil Geniuses. They're going to have to rely on, like, the Invis. It'll be like kind of like this Ricky or Bounty Hunter where you use it. Maybe they can try the Tree and Protector with the guys, but the Time Walk's not the best range. They don't have this natural Blinker. I mean, you'll buy a Blink on Troll, and you'll probably buy a Blink on Void, too, but they do come out a little bit later. Like, he might go for that Vlad's first. So we'll see if it's difficult for RTZ to excel because of all of this, but the final pick for TNC will be the Phantom Lancer. So they see an opportunity mid where they think this hero can go, and another very slippery hero. So two guys that are hard to lock down and could run into a little bit of trouble here if you miss a hex or something, either because of a Dark Pact or you can't tell which illusion is the correct PL.
Right, but again, there is the Chronosphere. It's the end-all be-all when it comes to the initiation for Evil Geniuses Overgrowth if they need it as well. It could be somewhat useful getting some of these slipperier heroes. Again, very fast draft. I mean, we're already into it, Trent. I think most people will give the advantage here to EG just because of who they are, their pedigree, for example. But TNC, again, a team that you shouldn't take lightly. How do you feel about the draft overall, and who do you think is going to come out on top at the end of the day?
In terms of the... I could see some trouble with the PL. As you said, Chrono, obviously very good against both Slark and PL. I mean, that's why we saw our Chrono earlier today, I think, was because of how good it was up against that Slark, but...
Yeah.
The PL, if they don't have that Chrono, Shadow Shaman has to get pretty close for the Aether Shock in terms of like trying to help find out which PL is real, and that's only the like that's really the only AoE they have. You know, maybe he could go for like a Whirling Axes or something, but that's pretty much it. So could be some slippery plays here from Cuckoo. If you can get things working right out of this mid lane.
All right, TNC, they've got a long road ahead of them again. A team that hasn't had necessarily the best results in the games they've played recently, but again. You get into the major and everything is different. Doesn't matter what team you are, doesn't matter how you've been performing. If you can get off to a good start, do well in the group stages, you can go a long way in these tournaments. And we'll see if that's going to be the case for this SEA squad. Tims will rotate up early on. Going to drop down a ward here right near this camp. Looks like he does block it just on the edge for the pole camp. Meanwhile, Crit also comes in, drops his own ward a bit kind of more aggressive just to get some lane vision as well. Other wards being dropped down. It doesn't look like it. It looks as if, though, there is Zai kind of coming in.
Yeah, but what happened down here was he came down into these trees and was immediately spotted by Raven, but of course, then he just goes invis. So the ward could be anywhere. Trian, of course, can do all the same things as Ricky in terms of using items out of invis and skills out of invis.
Oh, so. Shackles. Tim's going to get caught. Arteezy doesn't go open wounds. He has the feast, as he probably should. Same age coming in and Pale coming out. Crit going to get chased down. There's the Spirit Lance already in some trouble. EG might lose first blood here. One more auto attack will do it, and it's going to be Cuckoo that secures that kill. So aggressive play, and again, going on a Ogre Magi with 8 armor at the start. Pretty beefy boy.
Yeah, Tim's well known for his Earth Spirit, especially. I'm sure he probably has a mean Monkey King, too. In terms of, you know, he loves to be this aggressive kind of a player. So Ogre, not exactly a hero that tends to fit him. But in this situation, trying to go on an Ogre early can be a little bit tough. You know, this guy's got 8 armor right now. Kind of scary. So with that 11.4 regen with the Tango too, and just the naturally sits at like 4 or so. In terms of his HP, he's going to be very annoying in these lanes. Has a Fairy Fire to play around with. So not going to be the easiest task for him to deal with here.
I will say Crit's kind of tanky in his own right too. Surprisingly so for a Shadow Shaman. He's like 640 HP and like he had 5 armor. A moment ago, and it was under the tower. He has 2 now, so that's the difference maker. But we'll
Looks
see
like
what
while
we
were watching that. Raven had some issues down bottom too. Wasn't able to get the bounty rune. Yeah, he went back to base.
I didn't know he was getting harassed that badly. Wow. Okay. All right. So they will at least zone out Raven. He'll TP down bottom. He is going to get some help in the form of the CM, but Rior might want to go for a Frostbite or two at the beginning of this game. Zai is going to be up in the high ground. He's going to use the Nature's Guys. Comes in, gets off an attack. Doesn't get the bash though because.
Yeah, little gap there, the trees, because of the stairs.
Exactly.
Unfortunate.
Meanwhile, top lane. An aggro dual lane, Nyx, as well as an Ogre. And Arteezy might not have the best time early on in this game.
Similarly with Raven, though. I mean, Slark, a hero that, of course, doesn't do too well before level 6. And they're forced to use the Sentry just to counter the tree. And look, Zai's already found it. Puts his own down. Oh, misses the Tango. Oh, he needs to use that Tango. Oh, he missed again!
Jeez, there's battling happening everywhere. I don't
tree,
know what's
dude.
Going on. Next assassin getting chased again. Shackles back up for Crit. He gets 2 of them off. They should be able to get this kill. No spike carapace, no impale. Crit will pick up the return kill after dying early on in this game. Now down bottom lane, Raven getting caught. He does have his pounce and he will make it out in time, but a lot of damage being done already. He has to salve up early on. So a lot of aggression being placed, and EG starting to find their rhythm here in these 2 lanes.
Not too shabby. I am a little worried for Raven though. I mean, already he has suspended salve and they're just right back at him. You know, they have the 4-man shield,
Jeez.
And you have to do this build now, right? Because of these safe lane carries. If they want all that regen, they can't come down with 4-man shield. So he's sitting here even without a stout, and creeps are coming under his tower.
Yeah, he's getting kind of shreked here, to be honest. Like, he has 3 last hits, which is more than I thought he would have. But meanwhile, mid lane, Sumail and Cuckoo going toe-to-toe. 7 last hits for Cuckoo, 9 last hits for Sumail, so already a pretty good start for him with ranged axes. Doing some serious work, but... Yeah, this starts looking like an okay laning phase after that kill top lane trend.
Honestly, it's impressive from Sumail. There's a pretty big gap there in terms of the overall damage.
Yeah.
Like, I mean, the one thing about PL, though, is he does have one of those like weird averages because his minimum is 62 and his high is 84, so you can run into some weird problems when you're CSing, but he's got the Quelling Blade, and Sumail's only working with a Wraith Band. He's still doing very well. I mean, typical Sumail, of course, but
yeah,
it's not the easiest thing to avoid all these denies.
To be expected at this point, I suppose. Doing some nice damage. He has melee whirling axes if he wants to use them. Now Cuckoo needs to be careful. The Doppelganger will come out just in time just to make it away. And a bit sketchy for both those heroes. Meanwhile, bottom Zai took a lot of damage. So something to just keep in mind. You'll have to back up and regen up, it looks like.
Yeah, probably not worth using the Shrine. Yeah, he wants to save it for his offlaner himself, yeah. So... Just make the movement back to a shrine inside the base. And we should bring that up too as well with what we just saw with the Whirling Axes. An important thing about PL versus your Keepers of the Light or your Troll Warlord, he can dodge out that blind by using the Doppelganger. So go watch out for that in the later stages of the game.
Man, he's going in, Whirling Axes. Oh, the melee almost didn't hit there for a moment, but does now. Now top lane, Shackles coming out the Ogre, Impale will come through. And they're going to turn their attention to the Nyx instead. Again, very tanky on this Ogre Magic, but... Actually, a lot of damage coming through. Open wound still ready, so is Rage. So RTZ just saying, listen, I know it's an aggro dual lane, but I can still man fight you pretty well.
Samh doing very well, though. One of the stronger players on TNC. Has quite a few signature heroes for himself, like his Nature's Prophet. Always used to be one of the bigger ones, and his Nyx is very good as well. So sitting at 14 last hits, just tied up there around the same mark as RTZ. They will start to bring up Zai, though, and this is where things get a little bit sketchy. You know, you're not too worried about the Shadow Shaman, but this Treant's here. There's no ward back here, anything to spot TPs, so... Could be a little bit of a shocker when
the Crit walks
stun
up,
comes
they're going to shackle here. Impale will come out. That's been used, and Crit running in, but Sam H looks like he understands. He needs to back himself up at least a little bit. Zai has not been spotted bottom, but Samich walking perhaps a little too far up there. There's going to be the bash coming in. Crit looking for the shackles, but gets off the spike carapace perfectly. So Samich says no. No thanks. Meanwhile, mid lane, Sumail almost getting the kill. Doppelganger is up. Cuckoo and Sumail, man fighting like crazy. Dear God. Put your fists away, guys. Chill out for a second.
And it does look like it'll be Sumail getting the room, though. So nice little advantage for him as he spots that. Yeah. And he'll just send back the bottle.
Yeah, doing pretty well for himself right now. Salves up 23 last hits, 19 of the PL. So again, Universe also very good farm bottom. He's 1v1ing against Raven. And right now, Raven just cannot do anything. They'll rotate Tims as well as Rior up top lane. I feel like this rotation needs to work. Otherwise, they're just not getting enough out of it.
This is what you run into when you run a Slark. This is one of those big problems, is if they send down a very strong offlaner, like a Timber or a Legion Commander or a Faceless Void, in this case, that early 4-man shield, and he didn't have one on the Slark, you run into so much trouble, and your supports just have to leave, because you need all these levels to get 6, so you can at least catch up and farm.
Sumail has a pretty good idea of what's going on right now. They know they haven't seen any supports, both top and bottom, so he sits pretty far back towards this tower. They'll just take down an illusion or two, but it looks like the smoke is going to break, and Tim's is standing right on top. That's his own Observer Ward, just kidding. So yeah, they will scan. They'll find him anyways, Observer Ward or not. But he does end up dropping one down on the high ground. All right, well, again, kind of a waste of time here from TNC. I feel like they're starting to lose a lot of efficiency on the map.
Yeah, it's difficult. Rior can't really do anything but jungle. Just a tough kill to get top with his Treant, as well as his Lifestealer, hard hero to gank early on. So you just have to settle for getting a little bit for yourself while your Slark is just, again, desperately trying to get to level 6. But things are a little bit better for him. He's got the Sentry to watch for Zai showing up, and the wave was pushing a little bit into him. But at the same time, Universe now about to get close to 6, these two range creeps. I might see a rotation down to help him, or even just a Trance coming out.
Chronosphere going to be a huge ability this game. Raven's sitting at level 4, so again, forced to kind of pull, get some farm that way. 14 last hits. Again, he could come back later on down the road, but he needs some room.
Right now, he's not getting that range creep with Darkrai.
Yeah, rough game. Rough game for Raven down bottom. Universe pretty much on the opposite side. Meanwhile, Battle Trance will come. Sumail will take some of these creep camps. So it's begun. Level 6 for Sumail himself.
And now the Universe is 6, this is a big problem. You can't be here this low as Raven, because he knows the threat of Battle Trance is there. And until he's 6, like, what are you going to do? You're just going to get chronoed and battle tranced and die.
Exactly. Yep. And there could be another hero that rotates in as well, which they could absolutely 100% get the kill without it, perhaps. But we'll see. We'll see what they're going to do here. They have given up the mid lane. There's nobody here farming it for EG. Not yet, anyway. So Cuckoo getting bloodlusted. I think maybe the Ogre was around mid. Decided to head out of there for Sumail. He says, we'll just take the jungle farm instead.
Raven just hanging back, waiting until they spot Universe.
Man, Raven is so juicy. Look how low he is right now. And they just... Universe obviously doesn't have the vision for it, but...
Yeah, it may have been 5 months since he's played the hero, guys, but still looks good. Second on net worth, all 3 cores from EG up top, but it's followed by a 4 block of Radiant Heroes. However, the gap is starting to widen quite a bit. We're almost up to a 3k lead here at 7.5 minutes for the side of EG.
Yeah, not a good start again for TNC. You can get things back going here once Cuckoo starts getting some farm. His net worth is the only one really close to EG's. Throughout that Spirit Lance,
Slark
looking
for
tempting.
Crit. He's going.
Battle Trance, they're going to find it. There's the Chronosphere. Can they bring it down? One more stun. One more bash, not enough. They get the stun off for Tims in time, but the Time Walk is there, and the auto attack will do the job. Now he goes for the TP. They've already used the Fire Blast and the Frostbite, and he will make it away. So Universe just dives the tier 1 tower bottom, and TP's right in front of 2 heroes.
It's like, you know what's coming, and you can't even do anything.
Yeah.
Yeah, if double supports trying to back you up, and the pounce was there, but hell of a chrono, of course, from Universe, just on the tip.
Man, to feel like that futile in that bottom lane, I don't know how Raven's going to find anything this game. He's still not level 6, he's very close. One more creep will do the job, just about. Impale top lane, RTZ also finding really good farm. Midas is done for him. Into phase boots next. And then, of course, Sumail, the lowest one in terms of the top 3, but he's starting to get some extra gold going his way as he has a double damage when he just clears the creep wave real quick. All right, man.
At least they have the Slark at 6 now. So Raven, like, he can catch up pretty fast in the jungle. He's got this Iron Talon. He knows that's where his life is going to be. But you can just hear it, right? This non-stop trance. You're just like, oh my god, this troll. He's just getting so farmed across this map. This Lifestealer we can't kill. This Void we can't kill. They're all so survival. They all have their little niche ways to to live through these ganks. So you're just relying on this PL getting absolutely massive this game.
What was the plan for TNC in the first place? Get Raven farm, get a Shadowblade, and then start invading the jungle? Well, I mean, I'm not sure if they could have done that even with the Shadowblade, even with Raven being farmed. What do they need to get done?
Yeah, I think they're envisioning like a decently strong hero against Lifestealer, right? You know, he's not a Weaver or something, but at least he can go into the Shadow Dance. There's nothing something like a Lifestealer could do. But they're trying to get aggressive now with this Bloodlust on Cuckoo and Crystal Maiden, but this Shadow Shaman's soaking mid. They can't even
get him. They do see Sumail with the ward, and they're going to come right in. Spirit Lance, the Crystal Nova comes out. Can they bring it down? The Whirling Axes, the Living Armor is there, the Frostbite, the Vendetta gets it done. Now the Impale misses on Universe, but Tim's still coming in. They have the Fire Blast. They'll use it instead onto crit. Meanwhile, Doppelganger comes back through, crit getting low, Shackles going, but he gets cancelled instantly as he's taking too much damage, he needs to leave. Universe also time walking out, the Spirit Lance will go. Good turnaround, okay. TNC, they sort of stop the bleeding a little bit. They get Cuckoo some extra farm and some kills, and they give some room for Raven bottom, Trent.
Yep, great support play. Having that ward there, just catching out Sumail getting a little bit greedy, especially with the Nyx at level 6, as he was almost there himself, just roaming on through. Nice play by Sam Age, got the Carapace off onto the Shadow Shaman to reflect the Aether Shock, doing like half of Crit's HP.
Yep. It's a rough game for Crit, kind of, if they get caught in these positions.
And even drawing Universe up there, right? That's more space for Raven. You know, he's not getting bullied out of his lane at that moment. He's getting a little bit of gold.
He's back up there, man. He's tied with the Nyx Assassin now. Sumail, meanwhile, Whirling Axes. Cuckoo will pop the Invis rune. They shouldn't have detection. Not at least on Sumail. And he'll be able to go back in, just leech some experience if he wants to. Maybe set up a kill, but nobody's nearby. Again, just kind of getting tabs on these.
Just takes the last hit.
Yeah, that's classic. He needs to maybe think about running, though. Doppelganger will go, and that will keep him alive. And the rotation from crit a little bit too late.
And he's gone for the max Doppelganger this time. So we've seen some different builds for PL, but the Phantom Rush, kind of a cool skill these days where it gives you that bonus agi. So the more levels you can get onto your PL, the stronger and stronger he'll start to get, especially those little illusions that he's popping out everywhere. But so far, so good. You know, he's hanging out near the top of the net worth. However, Arteezy, again, is just... This is a game where he's getting way more love than he usually gets.
Yeah.
I love that because the troll just away. Falling to the jungle. He doesn't really need that much help in lane, of course.
Arteezy impaled up. There's the Crystal Nova. He does have Infest the Frostbite. Good rage in time as the Fire Blast wasn't there. The TP Vendetta isn't enough damage. One more auto attack. The tower was not hitting him. If it was, it would have gotten the kill. Nice TP from Arteezy to make it out in time. So a gank very close to successful, but not so for TNC.
And he'll pick up that armlet recipe so he can head back to lane and then just slowly grab his armlet out of these side shops here. Crit just getting on here, looking for a good ward. Under attack. Of course, it's kind of tough to just drop wards in this part of the map because they're just going to get dewarded. You know, they're just going to triangulate it using the Slark, so I'm just going to drop a sentry down instead.
That is the one advantage. The vision they've got going on. It's pretty good. Anyway, TNC just trying to make as many rotations as possible, sort of get everything going their way in terms of the lanes. Did a lot of damage to this tier 1 mid, but already you can see Zai's got it back up to half HP, the classic. In the meantime, Arteezy rotates bottom with the Universe, and they take the tier 1 for themselves, so... Good stuff.
I mean, you saw thinking anything.
Yeah, it's not easy. This has been a pretty good draft so far for EG. It's pretty much firing on all cylinders. The only thing they lost was that Crit died early on in the game to first blood. They lost a couple of other heroes over towards the shrine. But again, Arteezy was just farming away.
Sam H is getting quite a bit of space up here, though. Like, he's got a little bit of a threat here. They didn't want to just bring the Lifestealer right back up. Zai can't just, like, freely farm up these creeps or anything. He's just, like, soaking a bit of experience. Then he'll grab some under the tower. But overall, the fact that you can see the Nyx, maybe that's just kind of a benefit in itself for EG. They don't have to worry about these rotations. Now, he is coming through as Crit does, too. Yeah. Might be dead.
Vendetta, Impale, Crystal Nova. This should be a dead Shadow Shaman. But the Living Armor comes out in time. And they get the War Trap off. Crit will turn it around. The Shackles are there. Do they have another Frostbite? They do. They will get the Spike Carapace that gets the kill. And Samage will still fall for this. It's a trade that's really not that beneficial. Crit doesn't really add that much value. The only good thing is that they do use the Serpent Wards at the very least. But even that's not that great.
Yeah, they tried to break one of those wards down to let Samage out, but not quite in time.
No.
So, actually, it looks like it's a favorable trade overall towards the Radiant, I guess, just because the net worth differential. So,
yeah.
There's that.
When you're behind, jump in, Chronosphere Universe, they'll find him. The Battle Trance is up as well. Sumail does walk in, so Cuckoo might actually be okay until he gets bashed up by Universe. Now Rior is going to get chased down as well. He's like, please, no. Tim's coming in. Fire Blast, Bloodlust. They'll have Raven. Maybe they can find some kills here. Sumail, tough to bring down. That Living Armor. They have to pop Shadow Dance. Sumail somehow still alive. The body blocks from Tim's are perfect. The Impale is there. Can they get this kill? They will. So the trade is one for one in terms of your mid laners.
That's finally a little TNC, bit of the lack of damage of the Chrono showing off there is now Tim's.
Yeah, I believe he might be dead too. Universe going to come in. Get text up. He did use some six stars, which actually got him to a decent amount of HP, but not enough to save his life. So even when they get that kill mid on Sumail, they will find Zai actually top lane. He's going to go for the TP. Dark Pact might not be enough damage. In fact, it's just not enough as Zai is able to TP home. Second time they've done that. First time, of course, was Arteezy. Speaking of which, we'll take a Crystal Nova mid. And again, though, the trade 2-for-1, favorable for EG.
Yeah, you can see his build too. Only going for the one in the open wounds. Just not really having the kill potential up top. It was only like this tree that was kind of like helping him. So yeah, the Feast doing so much damage to the Ogre and that little bit of a gank there. But maybe losing Sumail there, showing off the fact they don't have the most damage in the Chrono. Like just because of where he was positioned inside, he couldn't quite get the range with the axes. It was close. And I mean, that's how he got caught inside, just trying to get that little bit of a tap there. But
exactly.
He's got the Yasha for the move speed now. And kind of that standard sort of troll build. We'll see if we get the SNY to come out too. The old classic, but
Universe already has Vlad's and is working on an Aghanim Scepter.
Yeah, and that's probably the last Chrono where we're going to see that real lack of damage. I thought maybe he'd go Maelstrom first. So really showing how much they need that Chrono to kill the Slark over and over. That he wants the Aghanim so early on.
Spike Carapace maxed up for the next Assassin. Actually keeps him alive against Arteezy. He didn't reach there. So he'll be able to escape. But at this point, they really just want to try to find farm for him. Looks like he's going to be picking up the Midas for the next Assassin. On the other side, Cuckoo is going to be picking up his Diffusal Blade next after he has bots early on. So they have okay late game. I mean, you have a Fancy Lancer. It's not the end of the world. You have a Slark too, and they're sort of catching up again. They're still a little ways away, but oh, they might go on to this. Oh my god, they just blow him away. Shackles, Hex, Aether Shock, Whirling Axes. Sumail is able to find that kill with relative ease. Saying, okay, maybe the PL's in an okay position, and then he just gets absolutely run at and destroyed.
Yeah, just a nighttime vision, not quite strong enough there. It was almost day. Might have had a chance at spawning crit, but reaction's not quite fast enough there. A little bit greedy. And as you're saying, this tower, I feel like he's just been pounding away on this thing. Yeah. But Terrain Protector, ladies and gentlemen, good hero. This game, Zai also spending a lot of time in the jungle, much like Jarek did, but no Iron Town for
Sam
himself.
H has been spotted. There is a Sentry. They have a Chronosphere. Sam H does have Spike Carapace and Impale, but when you get bashed up like that, it's still tough. Impale will come out. He might actually be able to live, even with that Overgrowth coming through. Time Walk forward, they're not going to use it. They're going to say, the Chronosphere is done. We can't bring down the next Assassin. We'll try to at least do some damage to Raven, but Sam H just tanky enough that he gets the Shrine off, and they just don't have the damage there. As you mentioned, Faces Void Chronosphere, they need a bit more.
Yeah, not too bad, though. Good survival there. Now, they don't have the Vendetta for another 10 seconds, but it's almost back. So, Raven just looking to use the Shadow Blade, and one more second till he's got it. Crit has the Sentry here, and now Raven's in it. He's a quick Hex.
Yeah, he's walking right through. Hex comes out. Sumail, Arcane, very fast. Impale only onto one. Looks like it might have been onto two. Sumail in trouble. Do they have the Living Armor? It's on cooldown. He just used it. Not enough. And the Pounce connects. Raven going in. He does have the Shadow Dance. No Overgrowth. A lot of damage to Zai. Can they bring him down? One more auto attack. A lot of Essence Shift stacks coming in. Universe, again, no Chronosphere. They might find CMH, though. There's the Shackles, and it looks like they'll finally bring this Bugman down. Universe comes in, gets his revenge. He does buy as much as before dying, or maybe even after dying, but still. It's a 2-for-1 trade there, Train.
Oh, Raven, way in the back lines, looking for crit.
I don't know. Is this die worth it? He has no mana.
He's got no mana.
This is crit juking like crazy, and Raven can't find it. Now we'll go for the TP. They have no way of canceling it. Universe can't quite get there in time, so
jeez,
a good attempt
from
Raven, but yeah.
He almost got him. And yeah, that fight mid too, crit just out of mana. Like, he sees him coming in, so he goes for the one Hex, but doesn't have the Shackles or anything to help save Sumail, and that just leads into a little bit of a snowball additional kills there, so. All in all, pretty good for TNC, but this graph, man, it's still just inching further and further down towards EG. You can see it's bouncing back, but I mean, we're still at like a 5k lead here. And Universe is just about to be very, very frightening with the Aghanims, and then potentially a Blink, or potentially more damage.
So are you more afraid of EG in their farm? If you are TNC, do you want to try to get something going here? Just so that you can maybe sort of quell that lead, or what?
I mean, they still have some good stuff going for them. They have this Diffusal coming out relatively soon. Cuckoo, and that can be scary.
Oh, that is a war trap. Good Shadow Dance. The Pounce is up. Maybe he can survive this coming in. Samage walks through. Cuckoo's up here as well. He's actually caught in. Finally, I think he might be able to break his way out as he's bringing down all of these Serpent Wards. Now the Infest out. Arteezy Fire Blasted. The Impale to follow up as well. He's out of mana, and he's getting chugged down. Finally, Rior will help find that kill as they rotate pretty much all five heroes up top, and they will secure themselves two important kills. But mid-tier one getting pushed into by Samael. Zai will come through as well. He does have his living armor back up in five with Overgrowth ready. Oh man, will they be able to finally find a tower? TNC, again, against this freaking... this Tyrant Protector with living armor. It is not easy, as we have mentioned multiple times.
Yeah, that was a nice maneuver, though, from TNC. There was no TP on Samael or Zai, so they couldn't be there for that one. They're able to punish those Seers, despite it taking a while, like with the Infest and everything, nothing there. And the University.
Cuckoo, that was pretty cheeky, but I don't know if it's going to work out. Chrono's going to come through.
Oh, there's no troll?
He stayed way too long. It doesn't matter. He does enough damage anyways, Dash even without the Aghanim Scepter. And again, they cannot get the Tier 1 tower, man. God. Although, it's pretty nice.
Yeah, ticket defusal on Cuckoo. So, and he's now looking towards the Aghanim Scepter, of course. The new thing. It's pretty sick, I gotta say. Like, you get
Sunspan
a wave.
Likes it a lot. I know.
Oh, yeah, he's the fan. Except he rushes it first every single game.
Which, how do
Sunspan,
you feel about
fan, please.
It? Yeah, no, not that's a fan. Not a fan. Okay.
It's okay. But, yeah, so he'll get that up. Probably a Manta, too. And almost surprised he's not going Manta first, honestly. I would be a little worried about time dilation. If he gets caught out by that on Universe, that's a problem. Obviously, no more self-purging. So, well, we'll have to see if he gets punished because of going for the Aghanims.
DD picked up for Sam H, Tim's and crew. Meanwhile, mid lane, Arteezy. Doesn't seem to be too worried. He's going to get impaled. They have the mana burn as well. Can they bring it down the Fire Blast? He's got Rage, but he is dead. He walked up thinking he could absolutely survive given any situation, and boy, was at a quick kill from TNC.
Yeah, the mana burn, just no infest. He was trying to rely on that to get out, and smart play as well from the Sam H, of course. Not getting greedy, not going for the damage from the Vendetta, just saves the stun burst.
Samael will get caught as well. Here's the Spirit Lance. He's going to get caught, but the Whirling Axes will come through. Doppelganger on the high ground. Cuckoo maybe not wanting to be there. Tim's comes in with a Fire Blast, though. All of a sudden, they're going to turn two. So EG losing two quick heroes, and then
TNC. They're trying to keep the chain going.
Yeah, they want Zai a third too. One. They have the sentry up. Zai gonna get chased down. Do they have any more detection? Looks as if no. Meanwhile,
Raven
on the back lines again. Yeah, they really need to get some pushing going here. It's not gonna be easy. Chrono is not ready yet, but it will be in about 20 seconds. 34 for the troll. Living armor will commence and continue. There isn't a glyph. Something to keep in mind.
And look at them bouncing back this net worth chart. Like Slark, despite that horrendous start, he's only 200 gold behind this life slurk. Like, this is what this hero can do when he's given a little bit of space. And they're at their strongest point in the game right now. Think about TA and wanting to fight with like Blink and Death on all these items. PL's the same way. He's got this Diffusal Blade, he's working towards an Agnes, and he just wants to sync up with the Slark and get shit done.
Chrono onto three. Universe does it again, but can they find any damage here? Arteezy coming in on the edge. They want Cuckoo. The freezing field is up and ready to go. The Impale comes out. They will find that PL. They're trying to turn, but it's not going to work out. Rior, they've got to retreat. They've only lost one. Now they're going to lose same age as well. Potentially, the Shackles will be there, the Overgrowth on top, and the auto attacks from Universe and Arteezy are more than enough. They will end up losing the Tier 1 tower, but Trent, very good turnaround fight from Evil Geniuses there.
I believe that's what you call vintage Universe right there. So,
yes.
Very nice, Chrono. Catches two right on the tips, and now they move directly into the Roche pit. And two of the most important kills to get to, the Nyx to help secure this. Don't have to worry about him coming and messing you up.
Oh, but he buys
PL
back.
Too. Oh, they have a sentry, though.
They're not doing this quickly enough, by the way. Here comes Riven, gets hexed up. The Dark Pact is there, though. They're going to jump right in. They want Crypt versus the Shadow Dance. He's got Pounce ready to go. They don't want to overextend too far. Universe is coming back in. Impale misses. Sumail's coming right on through. Whirling Axes. PL is back up in three. And that's what they're delaying for on TNC's side. They don't want to go too far without their Phantom Lance or their main damage dealer early on in this game.
They do have the Aghanim Scepter on the Void, though. So Universe has it back up now. But the Mana Burn has
really
been
does.
Messing with them. Sam H throwing it out there. Burning down Universe, of course, the Illusion's doing it as well, so there are some troubles here. And how many Arcanes do we have? Only the one on Zai, so it can be very tough for them.
Oops, I'll keep that up a little bit longer. Yeah, it's something they have to be aware
of. Smoke, but it's spotted by this ward.
Is that ward? Yeah, that ward must have seen it. We'll have to see how TNC react here. They're going to head into the Roche Pit again. This time they don't have Serpent Wards, but they have Battle Trance. And again, look how fast this falls. They need to get in there, but boy, this thing dies quickly. And they will take it more than likely. Aegis picked up by Sumail. Just like that. That's all they need to do. TNC not in the best position. They rotate. They look to find farm, but Battle Trance just cleans up Roche so fast. It's insane.
Oh, they were close. So that does cost them that buyback that was on Sam H, not going to result in them saving the Roche themselves. Their Tier 1 tower, unlikely to be saved Tier 2 unless Sam H can make some big plays, but he's just sitting here thinking, man, I really wish I could use my Midas.
TNC clearly look like they don't want to give this away, but a bad fight here could spell disaster if they're not careful. Let's see who initiates first, or if they just let this go. The Fire Blast, Living Armor is up on plenty of heroes, though.
Look at that Mana Burn
on the
Universe,
Tim's.
Though.
Yeah, it's getting more annoying. But he has enough for a Chronosphere still, and the Time Walk, too. it gets mana burned a bit more, and then he'd be in trouble. But they do take the tier 1 tower, and not really much TNC could do there other than look on.
Could have dust too, but not going to catch anyone. So that'll be Universe backing away, and he will start eyeing up that Maelstrom. It's either that or the Blink, so it seems to be that they're maybe just going on a slower tempo, maybe content now that they have this Aegis. Don't really feel that big need. Oh, did he switch it up? Oh, yeah. Look at that. Okay, so that's the in-between item, right? Blink is the full initiation, Maelstrom's kind of the full damage, and this gives you a little bit of both. Very good against PL. You can just be Shadowblade underneath him, and then go for that Chrono play. Good scouting with the illusions.
Not gonna be easy for TNC to deal with. Ags is coming soon for Phantom Lancer. Game gets a little bit easier when he has that item. Now bottom lane, they're going to look for Arteezy. They have Impale Vendetta ready to go. They're going to find it. Can they bring him down? They need a TP in, and it's from the PL. Inside the creep, now we'll try to infest out. That was huge. What a play from Arteezy. Infest the TP is not completed, and then makes it away, making it look easy too. Damn, that was sick.
Yeah, that's pretty slick, gotta say.
The little things.
Yeah, crafty. So he gets on out of there, and Kugels has to keep on trying to push this top lane out, but it looks like it's EG who are coming up here. And with the threat of the snakes, it's difficult to try and defend this. Sumail going to think about it for a second here. Of course, yeah. It was Sumail who was having some PC problems as we began here, so probably the same issues, just popping back up.
Yeah, we'll get a quick reconnect from him. In the meantime, looking at the scoreline, 11-11 in terms of kills, more importantly, the net worth, 4,000 advantage for EG, which at 24 minutes, it could be a lot worse for TNC right now, Trent.
Yeah, it's not bad. They're catching up. Like, that Slark really was in trouble. But as they're bringing it closer and closer, EG did get the Roche, so that's bouncing back up to that 4K. And if you're this PL, this Agnes is going to be like in the same way the Diffusal Blade was. So.
Yeah.
Looking forward to watching this, of course. If you guys haven't seen it before, basically, you throw your old Spirit Lance, and then will like spread in an AoE onto other targets nearby, and that does include creeps. So it's a very good farming item too, which might be why he was looking to get it like before this Manta, because it can accelerate your farm the same way, but it also does more damage in the teamfights, because it creates them on the heroes too. Again, without that Manta, we really do have to watch for the time dilation.
Yeah, that's something to keep in mind.
It's just so good against like even just like Slarks, Weavers, everyone like
can
that.
I'm not sure if they could do this, but can they split up the map? You are against Battle Trance and a troll that can push very quickly. So I'm not sure. Is
I think
split
they know they can't.
Do?
I don't think they can fight Chrono, Eggs, or Snake, and Aegis. I think it's just too scary. And they're doing fairly well. Like, they're doing quite a bit of damage down here. Our Slark, by the way, is building Manta again. Same situation as earlier today where we had a Faceless Void versus him, so the time dilation.
Universe time walking away. Doesn't want to get caught. TP's coming in en masse. They're looking for a fight here top lane. They might find somebody. Arteezy. Again, has Rage ready to go. They might not be able to catch Crit. Well, Sumail looking to turn back in. Meanwhile, Zai is deep, but they have no way of spotting him. Not yet, anyway.
And, so Universe finally made his mind up on that Blink, eh?
did he pick it up? Yeah.
Yeah, he just... Maelstrom, Shadowblade, Blink. He didn't know what he was doing.
Sometimes it takes a while, man. You gotta really think about it.
But nice little play where he TPs down bottom just to create the threat of pushing them away. So immediately they all TP top, but with the Blink, he can move across the map very quickly. So he's already back here. David, stop the threat mid
Damn,
and bottom.
Dude. Look at that. You're right. That Aghanim's is pretty nifty. Fire Blast coming out. Arteezy, living armored up. They need to be careful. Wraparound gank coming in. Can they find this open wounds? Tim's just going to try to bait this out. Crit getting jumped on, and the overgrowth just in time. Can they get him down? Crit still alive. The Frostbite, the Freezing Field, the Impale onto two. Cuckoo getting low. Now Sumail again still has that Aegis Manta style ready as well. Freezing Field still going to work. The Frostbite is up. The Chronosphere on the back lines, but he did use that Shadow Dance just in time. Rior will fall. They do get the kill on the Aegis at the very least. That's it. Now Raven about to get caught. Samage nearby as well. No Impale. Shadowblade away. Sumail coming in. They've got the Bash from Zai. Now Cuckoo back up and ready to fight as well. Arteezy running low on mana. They don't have the Aegis anymore. This might be too much. They might have stayed too long. Arteezy and Sumail getting solo. Cuckoo finds himself a double kill. They will both go down. The Impale is not there in time for Universe. He is able to get away and then blinks out. But TNC, even through the Aegis, they're able to take the fight and win, Trent. What a great engagement for them.
Yeah, Rior God, honestly. That ulti was so sick from the Crystal Maiden. He just got so much done in that tree line. It's one thing to get the damage going, but mostly it was the attack speed slow. You had a troll and a lifestealer chasing after an ogre, and they couldn't kill him because of the attack speed slow that was coming from that Crystal Maiden. So exceptionally well played by him. And also, of course, that PL just... He survives through. He gets out of the fight for a moment. They collapse in onto one hero.
Oh,
you saw the Spirit Lance go to work.
Crits, good bash to come out. They might be able to bring him down. The Impale is there. However, the Chronosphere used to get its Agonim Scepter, so it's right back up. They drop the Serpent Wards. Uh-oh, Raven needs to leave. So too does Sam H. He'll pop that Spike Carapace, but they don't get auto-attack down. Meanwhile, Cuckoo comes in. He finishes crit off. They might have stayed for too long. Now with Chrono down, Zai's going to get caught. Time walk away. And all of a sudden, they're losing everybody again. Sumail TP's in. Rolling Axe will go. And right now, one for two trades so far. Will they continue on here for TNC? It looks like no. Man, this is getting very interesting here, Trent.
Yep, they're maybe just considering their options here. It's like, all right, we know we have to fully commit. We have to take this tower down. So do we think right now with the current heroes up and where we're positioned on the map, can we commit to this? Like, you don't want to run into this whole... you lose two heroes for nothing, so... this is not permanent damage as it usually is.
If they can find Sumail, it would be absolutely huge. He's going to get jumped on. Can they bring him down? Defusal's there, the Frostbite, and they do. And now they almost certainly can bring this tier 2 tower down, even with the Tramp back up in 2 seconds.
Yeah, and post Manta, he's going for a. Is that a Maelstrom? Yeah, he's not going for the BKB. So,
yeah.
Sumail going to continue to have these issues with this Fusil Blade.
I'm a little surprised. And all of a sudden, as you mentioned, right around the time where they picked up Zagat Inspector and the Defusal Blade, this is TNC's power curve. They're right at the peak of it at this point, to use an oftenly used phrase. But still, they're in a very good position now, as you can see by the net worth graph, indicating a 4,000 advantage for TNC. Meanwhile, top lane, Cuckoo just doing what he does best, split pushing with these ridiculous amounts of illusions. Meanwhile, Sam H is on the high ground. Do they have vision of him? They didn't see him. They pinged him. They might know that he's there. Meanwhile, tower living armored up, but the creep still working on it, slowly but surely getting whittled down. And it looks like they cannot contest on the side of evil geniuses. All of a sudden, they have one tier 2 tower left, and that is in the top lane. And again, it's pretty low itself, so they'll have to heal it right back up with this Tramp Protector.
Smell, we'll be back up here, so start to back away, but things looking pretty damn good. Only one tower left, as you're saying, and then Roche coming back in about a minute, or at least we'll know the time that is in a minute or so here. Figure out if TNC can secure it for themselves, but very well played so far. And we've brought this up to a 4K lead for TNC. So Manta can only do so much in these fights. It's going to be very difficult for Sumail. Basically relying on these Chronos now at this point from Universe. Of course, the same one you'd want to rely on, it's this guy.
Absolutely.
RTZ TP's mid, though, and I think they saw that, so it's like kind of obvious that they're doing something. Like, you got three heroes standing right here. Probably going to be some sort of a smoke play here. Then again, that just relies on TNC to keep these waves pushed in, try and just keep revealing who's inside the base, and that allowed them to advance into this jungle and try and get some vision down to these areas, perhaps even sneak one into the base. We've talked a couple times about the Slark today, but that whole idea of denying out that vision, if you can keep wards off this part of the map, that's going to make it more difficult for Universe to come out here and get one of these big three-man Chronos out of nowhere and bring them back into the game.
There's like no vision for EG right now, you're absolutely right. Denying
and look
there.
At this ward too, it just sees everyone walk in here. They just missed it with the sentry on EG.
Crit is probably dead. Just pops the Manta. He actually isn't going to stay around too long, so good living armor there. Actually tanky enough to stay alive in some of these engagements. But while this is happening, Cuckoo is top lane and working on the tier 2 tower himself. So.
And that's this ward paying off, though, because he knows that these heroes are in here. He knows there's a faceless void right on this cliff, so he doesn't commit to that kill, because he might get chronoed and die, and then you're throwing away this lead. And it's all very near when Roche could be up, and in fact, he's up very early, so...
Yeah. They do have the... Zai did pick up the gem, by the way. So they just dewarded that ward that you mentioned a couple of times.
Oh, and so. Courier's about to fly over the pit, too. So they'll see this.
Hey, look at that. They had to see that, right?
Yeah, I'm sure. So. They probably would have checked. They'd have known it was going over.
All right. Well, again, TNC looking strong right now, but it is not over for EG. Again, you talked about relying on the Universe Chronospheres. There's absolutely that. Arteezy's got some really good right-click damage, you know.
Yep.
Super Wards, so...
EG as a whole, of course, has also been one of the best teams ever in terms of capitalizing on the Treant ult. Not quite into the Solar Crest yet, but once he has that, he might even consider the Blink, and we'll have this kind of a double AoE strategy.
Right, here we
Radiant go. Vision, nothing here, so they don't know the smoke is happening.
However, they do scan. Oh, it's going to be close. It's going to be close, and it will spot them. It knows exactly where they are. And if EG go for this again, there's an illusion in there, though, perfectly placed, so they'll know as soon as Roche has started. But again, they kill it so quickly. They're waiting for this illusion to go down. Meanwhile, Observer Ward not scouting out Sam H, who is Vendetta.
It's so funny that they're waiting for this, and yet it's only just giving time for TNC, because they already know
they're
there. Man,
this is falling so quickly, though. They need a Blink stun, but they're not going to find it in time. They will take it. Aegis goes to Smail again, finally. EG getting back right on the board in terms of getting an objective done. So it will prolong them for another 5 minutes or so. Meanwhile, Raven is deep. Very deep.
That's a very impressive grab up from EG. Like, just trying to find that hole you slipped through with no vision.
Experiments to come out on RTZ, doesn't spread. The Bloodlusts are coming. Sumail's looking to jump in and fight. Whirling Axes, Tims is kind of on his own. They're heading in different directions right now. It looks like they wanted to get a ward down.
Oh, Cuckoo's ready to burn these defusal charges. He's got the recipe ready, just has it locked in his inventory. He's ready to spend. And no Manta still, though, so still the dilation, but clearly not giving him too much trouble lately.
Meanwhile, look at Nid. Slark is going in. Chronosphere comes out. They find Samage. Is it enough damage? They should have it. Samage spike hair paste just in time. Forced twice away. Then blinks. Samage makes it out. They get the tier 3 tower, and now EG, no Proto. And here comes Cuckoo. Look at all the illusions. Look at the frame drops. The freezing field. RTZ is going to fall. Crit should be next as well. The infusal is seriously going to work. The shrines are there. Will it be able to heal him up enough? Cuckoo just needs a couple of auto techs to get this kill. The living armor. Wow, Crit is surviving for a long time, but it's not enough. Sumail is still with that Aegis, but they decide to go for a different direction. RTZ down for 50 seconds. Gonna have another game one upset, potentially. Trent, it might happen. Fire Blast coming through, and they will bring Sumail down once. The Aegis is there. They're looking on this melee racks, and they might just get it. Cuckoo do some serious work here. Glyph, not available. Still down for a good half of it.
Man, Universe Sumail is even hitting the dilation, and Cuckoo got caught with it, but it doesn't even matter. He has so many illusions by the time they get him that not having a purge for himself is not hurting him the slightest. Very impressive stuff. That double four staff into blink from Samage, hell of a play in terms of overall teamwork. Again, it's Rior coming through and Tims. These guys backing up TNC, and just good objective gaming there with Raven in the mid lane.
I gotta say, I cannot believe he died, or I can't believe he didn't die. It's pretty insane, and he's gonna have an axe pretty soon too as he picks up the point booster as well.
That's the threat of committing to like one of these fights. You need that kill, ZG. You know, if you're gonna throw out your Chrono right next to your base and start a fight there, if you don't get that kill, you see what happens. They don't Chrono to defend Rax.
I mean, the smart thing was Raven was starting when they were all still up here in this area. Like, yep. He was right in that tier 3 tower.
Just beeline mid. He saw the creeps, and he was like, yep.
You don't need me here right now. I think what's more important is buildings. Again, though, it is only one melee Rax in a tier 3 tower. Sure, EG lost a couple of heroes in the process, and the net worth is starting to get a little out of control. 15,000 almost for TNC, but they still have the Chronospheres. They should eventually still have the right click damage from both Sumail as well as RTZ. The Mjolnir is now done. So two Mjolnirs this game. Very good way to deal with these illusions, which so far have been causing a ruckus for EG.
Yeah, those racks give so much money to supports, though. That's like the best thing ever when you're a support player, because now you can itemize into what you need to survive through these. So Tim's already had the Ghost Scepter and the Force Staff, but now he's a mech. And the racks, it gives Rior a Ghost Scepter for himself to go on top of his Force Staff. So now he's immune to this troll and this Lifestealer. Even if he can catch it before the Chrono, might be able to survive through that too. So they can just continue to keep making the plays that they're going with now. It's Cuckoo, you know, bloodlusted up, moving through this jungle. So they get under vision this time, though.
No, Zai still has the gem. I don't think he died in that fight. Yeah.
Sam H has one too, though, so this will be dead.
Yeah, if they want to. They're going to head directly over to RTZ. He's going to rage TP, it looks like. And I don't believe they have any way of stopping it that I can tell. So, nice job from RTZ to get out again, but again, these man fights have not been working out in his or EG's favor, for that matter. Man. The road to come back is tough for EG, but it's definitely doable.
Yep, always got to watch out for those Chronos, but he's still a ways away from any sort of like a refresher or something like that, so it's still not going to be the easiest of tasks. And even when they're leaving the base on the smoke now, look how close this wave is.
Yeah, it's in a dangerous position for sure.
Dire
TNC,
vision, nothing.
I think they might understand something's happening. They're backing up with some of these heroes. Drop a ward down. Really, if they could just get vision for EG, it's good. But again, as you mentioned, dewarding, map control for the Slark. It's very good. And they're going to go. EG, they're still at tier 2, so they can't quite wrap all the way around.
Think of their initiation. It's only Blink Void. There's no Blink on this Shaman, right? He's so poor. There's no Blink on this tree.
It's a good thing it's Universe, but they have to back up.
Not enough, though.
They canceled the TP.
They caught someone for a second.
Yeah, with Sumail.
They might think they're all here right now. Probably panicking.
Yeah, no. They'll see a TB back. It's actually, Crit's just going to deal with this. Living Armor back to range racks. All right, TNC feel a bit more comfortable now. Look at the net worth, though, for some of these heroes. 22,000 for Cuckoo and then 17 for Raven. RTZ's not far behind Raven, but, I mean, Cuckoo's the real monster right now.
Yeah, and Sam H is catching up here, too, with that Midas. He's got an Agnum's almost finished up. And that's very handy, not only for defending high ground, but pretty good for sieging. We've already talked about how good the mana burn is this game. Still no items that are really improving the situation for Universe. So if he just keeps getting whittled down, there's going to be this pressure on him to throw to Chrono. And that could result in him being forced to throw one that's not exactly ideal.
Yeah. I mean, they live and die by these Chrono series, as you've mentioned a couple of times. So, like, the only initiation is until Turian gets a blink, if that ever happens, or maybe even crit. But he's heading for 4 staff. All right, what's the play? I mean, TNC could clearly wait for Roche. They've got still a little bit of ways to go, but they're pushing in mid. Actually, they've seen RTZ bottom. TPs are going to come through.
He's doing what he can. I mean, again, they don't have the rage cancel.
Rage,
so
TP, yeah. Until they get a basher or anything.
Yeah, kind of surprised that Raven did go for that over the Scotty, actually. I mean, very good against the Lifestealer and the Troll, for sure. But with it already on the PL and how much they're spreading it over the fights, I thought maybe he'd be the one to get the basher. He'll probably just be forced into it next, though.
All right. Again, slowing down the game, winning. Impale, mana burn. The universe is just annoyed. A little bit a tickle from Stamage, but they're really just taking control of this map, Trent. I mean, you can't really get past the river if you're EG. In fact, you could barely get outside your base.
Yeah, Greaves are almost done here for Tims. And maybe that's what they're waiting on before they start poking away at the high ground a bit. Maybe even just the next Roche. Maybe a butterfly on Cuckoo.
That'll do it. That will do it.
That certainly will. Sumail nowhere near an MKB. And Arteezy likewise.
Man, these Spirit Lance illusions coming out actually lag the game a significant amount. It's like a new Wukong's command coming in. It's just like there's so many.
So you need what? Terror Blades, Wukong's command from Monkey King, PL, the frame drop draft.
Back wall.
Yeah, back wall.
If you really want to blow up your computer, yes, the perfect draft.
Yeah, how to crash a Dota 2 server.
Impale comes in, RTZ had already used Rage, Raven coming in as well, a lot of damage being done, now Dark Pack's way pounce, mid pounce gets chronoed, looks so cool, but can they get the kill is the better question. There's going to be the overgrowth coming out, and Welp's eyes dead instantly. Now Universe time walking away, and without Chrono, this is tough. Here comes the freezing field, Universe in trouble will get dropped. Raven finds himself a dominating spree, and now looking for more, Pamps the Manta, and they're going to try to get this kill on Sumail, but they drop the Serpent Wards. Sumail still in trouble, is able to get out just in time, now forcing him away. The shackles are there, Raven got to get dropped down. RTZ forced to come in, and Universe forced to buy back, but they secure that big kill on Raven, and they're looking for more as well. Can they turn this around? It looks like they might stop. Universe, Chrono back at 25, time walks forward, still looking for Sam H. And, looks like that might be the end of it. Meanwhile, Cuckoo is just manning up. Here's the Impale. It's on to one. They blow away Sumail.
RTZ.
Man, these 4 stabs have been huge. And RTZ now out of mana. Universe getting low as well. He's got Chrono back in 9. Cuckoo still just sitting here. Completely fine. I mean, he's a little bit low in HP, but he's going to get earned right back up. And,
it's actually crazy how he's surviving. Like, he keeps getting hit by this time dilation, and he's so low, and he can't do anything. He literally waddles around, unable to cast spells or do anything, and his team just force staffs him.
Doesn't need a Mantis style. Come on.
Oh, big saves. The allies are there.
Good force staffs throughout the entirety of these fights. He will TP now to the top lane to split push that. Luckily enough for EG, no real, damage to their constructions. I guess they have to buy back on Universe. I think that might have been the only one. That's the wrong button. Looks like the answer to that question is yes. All right. When is Roche up?
I guess he did save Rax, but soon. 1 minute. That's the thing with Faceless Void, though. I mean, this is why the hero, I think, fell off in the first place, right? Was we always talked about cooldowns and how games were becoming like Tidehunter died, Faceless Void died. We've seen quite a bit today, though, thanks to these Slarks. But yeah, you know, you buy back and you have nothing. You can time dilate people. You look at these heroes like Nyx, he buys back, he's got Impale. This thing, it's on a 13-second cooldown. Stuns for 3 seconds, that's a lot of uptime. It's pretty good stuff. Centaur Warrunner, same deal. Slardar, good heroes. Faceless Void, very disappointing in that regard, but they're grouping up again. I've seen this story before, hopefully they'll go a little bit better. Do we have any additional jump?
I don't believe so.
Same story.
Changed. Yeah, so, I mean, they really just need to find the right chrono.
Or
and
maybe
not
another Roche
on the
again.
Wrong chrono. Well, the thing is, it's not going to be up, unfortunately, for them. They could stay around Roche if they want to and just sit inside the pit for the next 30 seconds. I don't think that's the best use of their time, though. They're going to walk through. I've seen a play where you walk up to this high ground, and trust me, it did not end well the last time I saw it.
Look at the wave mid. They're like, where is EG?
Yeah, they have a pretty good idea of where everybody is. Raven will walk right in. Spirit Lance Doppelganger coming out. They have the Chrono Spear. Can they bring this Cuckoo DL down? The Impala's out. They're looking to burn everybody down. The Freezing Field is there. The Overgrowth not doing nearly enough, and they will break down Sumail. It looks like actually still staying alive, trying to man fight. So far, so good. All of a sudden, they have to buy back and reorder. Nobody dead just yet for EG. They're going to come in Arteezy, just trying to toggle and stay alive. Is it enough damage? Cuckoo finally brings him down. The double kill is there. It takes him a long time, and now Crit is going to be next. Universe completely out of mana. The Pounce is there. Cuckoo finds himself an ultra kill, and GG is called.
Can
TNC.
Oh, Tim's boo. Stole the Rampage. What is this?
Oh, man. That's
how dare you? Yeah, very impressive stuff.
Man.
Did you see how much they had to spend to kill Rior in that last fight? They threw like four spells at the guy because first he gets entangled because he's ulting, and then he just pops his Ghost Scepter, so they can't right click him anymore, so they have to Aether Shock him, and meanwhile, this PL is just annihilating the rest of your team.